Why did you let them do this to you? I know it's nothing. With you, it's always nothing. Everything is a joke with you. School's a joke. Life's a joke. Giuseppe, you're 20 years old. You're a man, and that's a serious matter. In the name of God, what's going to happen to you? Giuseppe, you're a cross I can't bear anymore. I want to talk to your father.
Oh, no.
I know he's working. Well, let's go to his place of business. Dead. Two men in the house and I have to do everything.
My fault. I should have fixed that door. But I had more important things to do. You show her this. She'll feel better. I have to see a man about the job.
Good. And then you can unload Nino. And after that, you can clean up the mess in the house. What's that?
Diploma.
Diploma. Graduating in April. You. The donkey of the class. Whose idea was this? Ah, I see. Where is he?
I have a special diploma for him. I graduate him right through the roof.
Giuseppe, Giuseppe, you think I kept you in school all these years for this piece of paper? You think it didn't break my heart to see you a grown man among schoolboys? But at least I knew where you were. A place to go every day where the sisters could look after you. No. What will I do with you? What will you do with yourself?
I can work as a carpenter, like Papa.
Carpenter? He hasn't driven a nail in 3 months. If you could be a carpenter or a shoemaker or a blacksmith, I'd be the happiest mother in the world. But you can't, Giuseppe.
You can't, you understand?
There you are, my son. Like Nino, you'll tug and strain to the end of your days. Expect the worst, then you won't be disappointed. Now go, unload Nino.
Nino. Nino. Look. Diploma. No more school. We are going to work. La 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 la.
Ha! Ha! Dame mezzo mare, Michele, Michele, ma. E natta mezzo mare, Michele, Michele, ma. Poi natta
la 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 la. La 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 la. Ha!
Fifty pennies a day and you are singing. Huh? 50 pennies a day and you are singing.
Look. Look.
You've had too much sun on your head.
Oh.
The Baron.
Idiot. Stupid imbecile. Look what you have done. My vines. I'll kill you.
Giuseppe. The bailiff has come at last. He's taken the house to clear my debts.
Baron Marco.
The Baron? Here, at our house, you're crazy.
I ruined his vineyards.
Giuseppe! Giuseppe! Are you there, my son?
I just remember something. I have to see a man about the job.
Giuseppe, we've been waiting for you. What have you done?
Oh, not again, not now.
Is Baron Marco here?
Baron Marco, he never had such a carrozza. Come inside.
Don't recognize me, do you? How could you? The last time I saw you, I held you in my arms and baptized you.
Uncle Giovanni. Father Guardian Giovanni. He's just being appointed Father Guardian of the monastery at Martina.
This is Father Raspi, my nephew, Giuseppe.
He hurt himself in the service of God. Sit down, sit down. The wine, pour it. Cut some more cheese. Cut some more cheese. Come on. Eat, drink. This is your house.
That's enough, thank you.
Please, 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 Father Raspi. He's so nervous. Can you blame him? Never have we had such distinguished guests under this humble roof. My own brother, a prince of the church. Thank you, Almighty God, for answering a poor woman's prayer.
Francesca, please. I am only a doctor of the order. We have just come from Rome, where even bishops are as common as cats.
Don't be so modest. You are just like a Giuseppe. Hardworking, reliable, intelligent. Ask Sister Nunziata, she will tell you. My son was the brightest student in the liceo, graduating 3 months ahead of the others.
Would you like to see his diploma?
No, Francesca. I believe you.
I am not sure that this young man would fit into monastic life.
How can you say that?
Talk to him. Give him a chance.
Perhaps my sister is right. This is a serious matter. We must not be too hasty. Giuseppe?
Giuseppe? Giuseppe, come here.
Giuseppe, come here.
Sit down, my son. Sit down. Have you ever considered holy orders?
Priest.
We had something else in mind, Francesca. Something like a lay brother. We can always use a good carpenter, a mason, gardeners, laborers, whatever we must do in the service of Christ. I am sure there is a place for you at Martina. Agreed?
Let the young man decide for himself.
Idiot! Idiot! What do you want? To be under my feet all day? Stuffing your belly, never bringing a cent into the house? Is that what you want? Losing one job after another like a worthless father? No wonder they call you Bocca Aperta, because you are a brainless idiot. This holy man of God offer you the chance of a lifetime and you don't want it. Why? Why in God's name?
Mama, you know, I can't do any of those things. I'm not a carpenter. I'm not a mason.
But at least try.
I've tried 100 times. I can't do it. I know it.
Signora, perhaps Giuseppe knows his limitations. Monastic life is hard, very hard. The discipline is severe.
But Father Raspi...
There you are, Francesca. It was Giuseppe's decision to make, and he has made it.
Mama!
Giuseppe, my son.
What is it, Mama?
These attacks. I didn't want to worry you with them, but I'm not long for this world, my son. Oh, Giuseppe, what's to become of you after I'm gone? Who's to take care of you?
Mama, but don't worry. I'll find a way.
Promise me, son.
I can't be taking anything.
Go to the monastery with your uncle. Live the life of a holy man. What more can a mother ask of her boy? To know that God watches over him, protecting him from the wickedness of the world. Oh. Promise, Giuseppe.
I promise. Anything. Anything, Mama.
Francesca. Perhaps you had better rest a while.
Rest? We are going to eat, drink, celebrate. This is the happiest day of my life. Come on, what? Get some more.
Your sister is a remarkable woman, Father. If she were a man, she'd be a bishop.
She'd be the Pope.
Have all you're going begging. Father Raspi is waiting, Your Eminence.
Where is he?
Up at the gate. Charity and love are capital virtues, Brother Giuseppe. But my favorite virtue is promptness. Well, my brothers, the time has come. As I told you, today you begin a new spiritual experience. You will go down into the villages and beg. I see there are still some doubts coming from good families. Some of you do, it's only natural. Is it lawful to beg? Hmm? Is it moral? Is it good for the soul? Well, the great Saint Francis has given us the answers. Yes? And he tells us that it is indeed lawful and moral and good to solicit alms for the monastery for humility's sake. And as an antidote against the poison of vanity. The poison of vanity. Fill the baskets, my brothers, and God be with you. One more thing. Remember, we have our own garden. No vegetables, please.
God bless you, my friend. Saint Francis.
Well done, my brothers. Well done. It's good to see that Christian charity isn't dead in the world.
Father Respi, it was such a rewarding
experience.
Now we
know what you mean by true humility.
Praise the Lord for that. Take them to Brother Leon, the refectory. Your sandals. The donkey. What happened? Oh, Mother of Mercy.
I tell you, Father, this man has demoralized the entire monastery. He's got to go back where he came from.
Father, I beg you, be a little more patient. What could Giuseppe do? There are alleys in Lecce where the devil himself would not go. We should thank God he came back alive.
Our friars have been begging in the streets of Lecce for 3 centuries, Father. They've always been welcomed and respected.
Then why not Giuseppe?
Because he's a magnet for trouble.
Oh.
But what other explanation is there?
Where is it?
What?
The donkey. You sold it, didn't you?
No, I didn't.
Don't lie. You sold it in Lecce. What did he do with the money?
I don't know. I told you before, I don't know what happened to that donkey.
Have you been to confession?
Yes. This morning.
Who'd you go to? Not Father Raspi?
No.
Oh, he'll never forgive you. Oh, you're stupid. You know that? Everybody said so. All the friars. I've got this, but you've got a crack here. You don't belong here. You get to work everywhere. In the kitchen, in the garden, here, in this beautiful Donatello cloister. And me, a stable boy, shouting dong all day.
I would love to work in the stables. I think it's wonderful.
Oh, how stupid you really are. And if it wasn't for your uncle, I'd be here doing your job. And you'd be in the stable with the donkeys, where you belong.
Look, a swallow's nest.
Then you better get rid of it. That statue's 200 years old.
Look.
Stupid. Take them down.
Oh, it's too young. It can't fly. I don't think the Madonna will mind.
Come in.
For you, Father Guardian.
Thank you, Father. Come in, Giuseppe. This letter just came. It is from your mother. She needs you. Your father died last night.
And so he's gone. For all of his faults, he was a good man. You know something, Giuseppe? He loved you more than he loved me. Would you believe it? My life is easier now. Your father was a wonderful man to love, but not to live with. There comes a time when living is more important than loving. When he was alive, I couldn't sleep one day where he was. Now I know. And I know where you are. Are you happy, Martina?
Yes.
How handsome you are in your brown robes. You opened their eyes at the funeral. They learned their lesson today. The whole town. For years they've said you turn into a drunken sot like your father. But today we show them. If only my brother could have been there too. The father got you.
I have a letter for you. From Uncle Giovanni.
No. No, he can't. I won't let them. They can't do this to me.
What is it?
They have thrown you out. They don't want you back because you are an idiot. You have been nothing but trouble since the day you got there, since the day you were born. What have you done this time? Tell me. Answer.
I broke a statue.
For breaking a little statue, they throw you out like a dog?
It wasn't little, it was big. It was bigger than you. And over 200 years old.
200? An old piece of junk. And for this, they wreck a human life. We will see about this. A fine brother I've got. Come on. Come on. Stop it. Tell the father guard and his sister is here.
No, wait a minute. Now.
Mama, they are singing Vespers. It's sacrilege.
Come on. Than God. Giuseppe, come here. My son, your nephew, flesh of your flesh, what have you done to him?
Richard.
What sin did he commit? Murder, blasphemy, adultery? Why did you throw him out?
Richard,
who do you think you are? The Pope? You, of all people. My son broke a statue. And what about you, Giovanni? Remember Giancarlo's saloon on your 18th birthday? You broke every glass, every bottle, every chair in the place. Shall I go on, Father, Guardian? Remember Rosa Esposito and Amaya.
You have blasphemed enough.
What about Giuseppe? Does he stay?
We will discuss it in my office.
Stay and sing with your brothers.
Charge here.
You look wonderful.
Oh, you think so?
Like the father Jonathan.
Oh, yes? Oh. How is it in back?
Oh, it doesn't show at all. How are things in the kitchen?
See for yourself. No more calluses, no dirty fingernails, and the best of food.
I'm happy for you.
Advance. You're jealous because I took away your job.
No, no, you're wrong. I'm happy here at my home, my family.
Home? A pigsty? You're in trouble again. You know who's coming tomorrow?
No.
The Vicar General of the Franciscan Order, Bishop Dulce himself, to make his annual inspection.
Is that true?
You know what that means? It means the stable had better be clean or out you go. And this time, running home to Mama won't help.
I've been so busy. I will try to catch up tonight.
It's too late now. It's hopeless. Hopeless. The stalls are filthy. They're not fit for goats and donkeys to live in.
Please, Gobble, leave me alone. I don't want to be thrown out again. Please, I have to work.
What's this doing on the ground? There's a place for the harness. It's supposed to hang on the wall.
Go, boy. Get out of here. Get out! Get out of here! Get out of here!
Forgive me, I shouldn't have done that.
The finest wine in Italy.
Don't forget me at Christmas time.
This will be your greatest harvest.
The friars in Sicily grow a fatter olive.
Let me show you our lemon groves, Your
Excellency. Are we near the stables?
Your Excellency, you haven't seen the strawberries or the vegetable garden.
Later, later.
The wine press?
Take me to the stables.
This way, Your Excellency.
Very tidy, I must say. Who's in charge here?
Brother Giuseppe, my nephew.
Who's that?
A pig, Your Excellency.
Yes, yes, of course. Hard at work, I see.
Allow me, Your Excellency.
Wake up! Wake up!
How do you explain all this, Giuseppe? Well?
No. Show me.
We're late, Your Excellency. I almost lost the mother. She has been sick all week.
What men of you having 100 sheep and losing one of them does not leave the 99 in the desert and go after that which is lost until he finds it? St. Luke.
St. Luke?
Yes. This is the kind of young men we need in our order. True son of St. Francis. Good work, my son. And let it be a lesson to all of us. First things come first. Well, I see Brother Giuseppe is quite busy here. Help him to clean up the stable. I love the smell of manure. When I was a boy in Abruzzi, we were very poor, but we had a little farm. So there were two donkeys, a cow, and a little horse.
If we accept the traditional and the scriptural dictates of the Decalogue of the supremacy of the Father, then we must ask ourselves, does the glorification of the Son for his Father prove inequality in our consideration of the Blessed Trinity? And We must further ask ourselves, is this a supererogation of the Holy Ghost? For the answer to these seeming paradoxes of the Blessed Trinity, let us consult the Bishop of Hippo, St. Augustine himself, who says, truly, let them beware, lest the Holy Spirit be thought greater than both, because he glorifies the Son whom the Father glorifies, while it is not written that he himself is glorified either by the Father or the Son.
To sing that song in Calabria, not at all fast. Very pleasant here now. Oh, may I join you?
Yes.
No, no,
I'll
no,
get
no.
you a stool.
No, 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 no ceremony. Here.
Oh,
thank you. Sit down. Sit down. Give me a chestnut.
They're hot, Your Excellency.
How are the lambs?
Oh, they're sleeping. I gave them names.
Oh.
One is called Girolamo.
Yeah.
And the other one, Bartolomeo.
Beautiful night. Look at those stars.
Have you ever noticed? The longer you look, the more stars come out.
Yeah. I wonder why. Brother Orlando will certainly have an explanation.
Oh, yes. Brother Orlando, he knows everything.
I just heard him try to explain the Trinity. Now it's more of a mystery than ever. Always troubled me, the Trinity. You know, Giuseppe, I could never really understand it. Just took it on faith. What about you? Does it trouble you?
No. There are three persons in one God. Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, all in one.
Yes, but that's for a child. But it's small comfort to a bishop who's supposed to know theology. See, I'm a peasant, Giuseppe, just like you. A practical man. So I understand only what I feel and what I see.
Look, one blanket, and one, two, three folds in one blanket, three persons in one God, like the Trinity.
Brilliant, Giuseppe, simply brilliant. So now, let's talk some more.
Are you cold?
Oh, no, thank you. You know, seems to me that the more you study, the less you know, because when I was young like you, everything was so clear, so simple. But now, things you understand in your heart and soul, Giuseppe, are so difficult to explain. The Trinity, free will, first cause. Maybe you can help me.
Me?
You probably more than anyone. Do you mind my being here, Giuseppe?
Oh, no. No.
Well, then, let's have some chestnuts and talk.
And one night, when my parents were sleeping,
yeah.
I took my father's tape measure
yeah.
and put the donkey right in the middle of the two stacks of hay.
And did the donkey starve to death?
No.
No.
No, Nino ate both of them.
Oh, heavens, I'd better get back to my room before Father Raspi comes looking for me. Well, Giuseppe, I don't know about you, but it's been a most enjoyable night for me.
Oh, for me it was so. I'm only afraid I talk too much.
We both did, like two nuns in the kitchen.
Yeah, but I feel better now.
Have you ever thought of the priesthood, Giuseppe?
No. I can hardly read and write.
Reading and writing, any fool can do that. But the sacred calling is for a favored few. Comes from God. Think about it. Oh. Thank you for the chestnuts. Thank you. I'm sure the Minister General in Rome will be very happy with my report on Martina.
God bless you, Your Excellency.
Brother Orlando.
Yes, Your Excellency.
Congratulations on your brilliant analysis of the Trinity last
night. Thank you, Your Excellency. With your permission, I'd like to send you a new thesis I'm writing. An interpretation of the Aryan hymns.
Oh, by all means, of course. And now, Brother Orlando, I'd like you to do something for me.
It would be an honor, Your Excellency.
You know Brother Giuseppe?
The stable boy.
He's a brilliant young man.
What do you wish me to do?
Tutor him.
Tutor him? For what?
The priesthood.
But, Your Excellency, I don't think...
Then don't. Simply do as I say. Giuseppe deserves a chance. See that he gets it. And I charge you with the responsibility. Goodbye, my brothers.
Recite the 14th chapter of the first epistle to the Corinthians.
What man of you having 100 sheep and losing one of them?
No! Look again. I said Corinthians. There is more to Scripture than the Gospel of St. Luke.
But I like St. Luke.
That's beside the point. You've got to know the entire Bible. Now, the 14th chapter of the first...
It's not difficult, it's... I forget it as soon as I hear it.
You know, Brother Giuseppe, this is only an examination for the subdiaconate. If you pass this hurdle, then after a year of intense study, you will be examined again for the priesthood. Oh, it's a long, difficult road. But if you must fail, then fail like a man.
Bishop D'Urso says you will become a priest, and we must respect his intuition.
It's not the failing.
Then what?
I
don't want to leave here. I'd like to stay with the animals in the stable. There will always be a place for you here, Giuseppe.
Even if I fail?
Even if you fail.
Bishop Nicola is ready to begin the examinations for the subdiaconate. Your names will be called in alphabetical order. Brother Vittorio Arcangelo. Giuseppe Deza.
Giuseppe, I'll say a prayer for you.
Don't waste the prayer on me, say one for yourself.
Brother Giuseppe, the knowledge of the four Gospels is the keystone of our faith. As a candidate for this subdiaconate, you're expected to know them thoroughly. Recite for me, if you please, the 15th chapter of St. Luke.
Oh, yes, yes.
Recite it, please.
Now the publicans and sinners were drawing near to him to listen to him, and the Pharisees and the scribes murmured, saying, "This man welcomes sinners and eats with them." But he spoke to them this parable, saying, "What man of you, having 100 sheep and losing one of them, does not leave the 99 in the desert and go after that which is lost? And when he has found it, he lays it upon his shoulders, rejoicing. And on coming home, he calls together his friends and neighbors, saying, 'Rejoice with me, because I have found my sheep that was lost.' I say to you that even so, there will be joy in heaven over one sinner who repents more than over the 99 just who have no need of repentance."
Sherry?
Yes. I knew you'd like it, so I added a little more.
But don't tell Brother Cook. Has my work in the kitchen been satisfactory, Father Guardian?
Yes, yes, but keep it up.
Humility is a virtue too, Giuseppe. There are worse things than failure. Welcome back, my son.
I didn't fail.
You passed?
I failed. I failed.
Canon law? Aquinas? Epistemology and ethics? These are the most troublesome. At least I found them so. And this, the most important of all, the ordinary of the mass. You have a whole year to prepare yourself with the best instructors in the order.
I'll miss the stables.
The cobbler will look after the animals.
Uncle Giovanni, couldn't I stay in
no.
the stables? I will work hard.
No, Giuseppe.
Just to stay.
Obedience, Giuseppe, is the first rule. Pray, Giuseppe. Pray for help.
I don't envy you, Brother Giuseppe.
I don't pretend to understand you either.
But I wish you well.
The senseless man seeks in vain for wisdom. Proverbs 14.
True. But the fear of the Lord is training for wisdom. And humility goes before honors. Proverbs 50.
I'm sorry.
Sorry, glad, that's what you are. Drive me back to the stinking stable.
Gobo.
You? A priest? That I should be a bishop, the Pope even.
I'm not a priest yet.
And you never will be.
May I put my books down? My arms are tired.
I don't care what you do with your stupid books.
Donna! You stole her!
Keep her. She didn't do me any good. All those prayers. And for what? Back to the stable.
She's beautiful. No! Gobo! Gobo!
She belongs to the stable.
No, no! No!
Mm-hmm.
I will say this about Brother Giuseppe. He tried.
He studied hard, but I don't think he learned the first thing about canon law.
Or Latin.
Let's not be hasty in our judgment. Remember what happened at Brindisi.
Brindisi was elementary. In Naples, he'll be competing with the best scholars in Italy. We're asking for a miracle.
Shall we pray for one?
Brother Giuseppe, I knew you'd be here someday.
Your Excellency.
How are the lambs?
Oh, they are sheep now, Your Excellency.
Oh, yes. Yes, yes, of course. Has it been that long? And the studies, they've been hard, eh?
But mostly, I missed the stables. That's where I really belong. I shouldn't be here.
Let me be the judge of that, Giuseppe. There'll be many lost sheep to care for. I've already examined this young man. He passes. I'm not so sure about the others.
Of God, they throw him out again. Get out, you! Get out!
Mama, wait! I'm a priest!
Vagabond! Hey, you! A priest?
Yes, I'm the... Look.
I'm Father Giuseppe.
Sleeping.
Giuseppe has had a long journey all the way from Naples.
I brought my goat to be blessed.
My cow, she's dried up.
Patience. My son will take care of all your needs. You won't forget his people.
But when can we see him?
Mama!
He's awake.
Come in, father! What is it, my son?
Mama, my cassock.
Yes, my boy is ready. Here it is, father. Your cassock. You have visitors. He slept in my bed last night. Imagine, a priest in my bed.
To have a priest for a son, what a blessing.
There was always something special about Giuseppe. Maybe the others couldn't see it. But I knew all the time.
Good morning.
Good morning, father. Good morning, my son. You have visitors. Oh, no, no, you must go. You must go. Come on, go.
One day, St. Francis was meditating on his death. The state of his soul after...
Emil! I saw it with my own eyes.
What are you talking about?
It's Father Giuseppe. He's down in the stable.
We're all happy about Father Giuseppe's ordination, but let's not get hysterical.
But it's up in the air.
And so are you. Stop this raving and try to speak coherently.
I am trying, Father Raspi. But it's up in the air, flying around in the stable.
Are you crazy or are you drunk?
I tell you, I saw him. He's flying around like an angel.
Of course, just like an angel. Stay with him until he calms down.
Oh, no. No, I am not crazy. I'm not drunk. I'm telling the truth. Oh, I'm coming to my church. Oh, Father Giuseppe. Oh, Father Giuseppe.
Help me, Father. Help me. Have mercy on a poor hunchback, please. Please, Father, please. Please.
What is it? What can I do for you?
Oh, this. Get rid of it. This cross on my back. Please, Father. But please.
Go, boy.
I can't. I'm only a priest.
No. You're a saint. You can fly. You can do anything.
Take him out.
No. Father Giuseppe is a saint. He's a saint.
What's the matter with him?
Flying around the stable like an angel.
He?
Oh.
No. Like a donkey.
Welcome home.
home, Giuseppe.
Archbishop Dosso forwarded your holy orders.
You are very fortunate
to have a patron in such a high office.
And tomorrow morning you celebrate your first mass here at Martina. And we will all be there to share your joy.
My mistakes.
You'll have no trouble. Come, Father, you're just in time for dinner.
Aren't you excited? In case you forget.
Thank you.
How I envy you. Next year, you will be standing right here and I will be your altar boy.
Oh, I hope so.
It's on backwards. Hurry, hurry, hurry. We'll be late.
Scripta sunt ut credatis quia Iesus est Christus, filius Dei, et ut credentes vitem habeatis in nomine eius.
Laus tibi, Christi.
Father Giuseppe.
We want to be healed.
He can fly.
Yes, he can fly. I saw him.
Don't believe this imbecile story. He cannot fly any more than I can, or you, or you, or you. Get back home and behave like sensible Christians. If you want miracles, pray for them in your own churches. We have no magicians here, no flying monks.
And you, go back to the stables where you belong.
But he's fly, I saw him.
Liar!
Oh, no! No! He's fly!
Amen.
Father Giuseppe was, oh, I would say, 2 feet off the floor.
Thank you, Brother Tomas.
Brother Leo?
I saw exactly the same thing. Except that, in my opinion, Father Giuseppe rose much higher. At least 5 feet.
Thank you, Brother Leo.
Brother Alfredo?
He levitated exactly 19 inches, no more and no less. Because when I heard that the Vicar General was coming from Naples to investigate, I took the trouble to measure it.
Thank you, Brother Alfredo.
Brother Rolando.
I assisted at Father Giuseppe's mass. I knelt directly behind him. There can be no denying what I saw. He flew to the very top of the altar, at least 15 feet.
Thank you, Brother Orlando.
Brother Carlo.
Thank you, Father. I think we have heard enough from the brothers. If we wait long enough, I'm sure we'll hear that Father Giuseppe has entered into heaven. Brothers, this is not a laughing matter. In fact, it's more serious than I imagined.
But that is why we asked you here, Your Excellency.
Before we bother the Holy Father with our parochial problems, I suggest we try to clean up the matter ourselves.
Exactly.
Father Giuseppe. Father Giuseppe.
Giuseppe.
Giuseppe. Giuseppe.
Father Giuseppe, how was your health as a boy?
Health?
Were you often sick?
Yes.
There's a great deal of malaria down here in Calabria and Apulia. Were you ever afflicted with it?
Yes. Half the people of Cupertino had it.
Then you should know something about the ravages of the disease. They say it often affects the reason, isn't that so?
Yes. A boy in my class. Franco, he had it. But he's dead now.
But it didn't affect you.
No.
We requested these records from the parish in Cupertino. You weren't a very good student, were you?
No.
Without intending any cruelty, Father Giuseppe, they would indicate you were a very bad student. Why were you so backward?
Does your mind sometimes wander? Yes. Doesn't this condition worry you? Haven't you ever seen a doctor about it? No.
Think back, Father Giuseppe. Do you remember sustaining a serious injury? Did you ever fall and hurt yourself?
Oh, yes. Yes.
Did you ever fall on your head?
Oh, yes, many times.
Aridity sometimes shapes our character, Father Giuseppe. Was your mother ever sick, seriously sick, so that her judgment was impaired?
My mother was never sick a day in her life. She's strong in mind and body.
Shh.
Your father. He was a good man.
Wouldn't you say he drank to excess? Isn't it possible that it affected his mind?
My father was a wonderful man. He wanted to know about things, to understand. He studied poetry, music. He understood dogs.
This strange power of yours, how long have you had it?
A year.
And does it frighten you?
No.
But do you think the Blessed Mother is responsible for these levitations?
Yes.
Can other things cause you to levitate?
Other things?
Holy things.
Yeah, holy things.
What holy things?
The Holy Mass.
Oh, yes, yes, we know about that. What else?
Can you exercise this power at will? There are so many holy men here. You should be able to fly to Rome. Could you levitate up to there if we asked you? Please, try. Thank you, Father Giuseppe. I'm sure that this phenomenon is a temporary thing and will pass away. Be that as it may, there can be no doubt that here we have a case of divine intervention.
No. I'm sorry, but I must disagree with my distinguished brothers. I mean no disobedience, Your Excellency. And I speak with no personal malice. My feelings in this matter go much deeper than that. This man has deceived you.
Father Raspi. That's a grave charge.
I do not make it lightly, Your Excellency. This man makes a mockery of the priesthood. 19 inches. 2 feet. 3 feet. 5 feet. And finally, 15 feet. Now, clearly, someone is wrong. Or all of them. Why is there such conflicting testimony? Why is there such wide disagreement?
There may be disagreement on how high he flew. But there is no doubt that everyone saw him fly.
How did they? Or do they imagine they saw Father Giuseppe levitate?
What do you mean?
They were all bewitched by this man. All bewitched.
No, he couldn't have bewitched us. He had his back to us.
I repeat, bewitched. The same as the Indian rope trick. Hundreds, oh, even thousands. Duped into seeing a man climb a rope suspended in midair. A trick. A faker's art. The devil's genius. Even his ordination was a lie. And was obtained not through grace, but through the intervention of the devil.
Father Raspi!
I charge that Lucifer himself is working through this young man.
What are you suggesting?
Possession.
Oh, no, no.
Diabolic possession.
Father Giuseppe possessed by the devil. You cannot be serious.
Possession is a serious matter, Your Excellency. I do not take it lightly. Ah.
I understand your feelings about keeping this in the family. But it is my considered judgment that this sorcery is not a parochial matter. I believe it should be reported to the inquisitorial court in Rome.
But a scandal.
There must be some other way.
There is another way. There is. The prescription of the church in matters of possession is very clear. Exorcism.
Oh, come now, Father Aspie. We are not inquisitors. Look at him. Do you really believe there is a devil lurking inside that humble man?
There was once a Lucifer in heaven.
Must we go through with this, Your Excellency?
It's either that or wrong. Before we proceed, we must get his permission. Father Giuseppe. Father Giuseppe.
With your indulgence, Your Excellency, we'll get his permission later, when he's with us again.
Very well, Father Raspi. Purge the devil out of him and clear this matter up once and for all.
From your wrath,
deliver us, O Lord.
From sudden and unprovided death,
deliver us, O Lord.
From the snares of the devil,
deliver us, O Lord.
From anger, from hate and all evil intentions,
deliver us, O Lord.
From the lightning and the tempest,
deliver us, O Lord.
From perpetual death,
deliver us, O Lord.
The mystery of your holy incarnation, deliver us, O Lord. For your coming, deliver us, O Lord. For your nativity,
deliver us, O Lord.
For your baptism and holy fasting,
deliver us, O Lord.
For your cross and passion,
deliver us, O Lord.
For your death and burial,
deliver us, O Lord.
For your holy resurrection,
deliver us, O Lord.
For your admirable ascension,
deliver us, O Lord.
For the coming of the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete,
deliver us, O Lord.
In the day of judgment,
deliver us, O Lord.
In nomine Patris, et Filii, et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. You will please kneel down. It is the devil who gives you wings. The chains will prevent you from flying. Reminiscaris domine delicta nostra vel parentum nostrorum, neque vindictam sumas de peccatis nostris. Pater noster, qui es in cielo. Et ne nos inducas in tentationem. Recipio tibi, qui cunque es, spiritus immunde, et omnibus socis tuis undei famulum obsidentibus, ut per mysteria incarnationis, passionis, resurrectionis et ascensionis Domine nostri Iesu Christi, per missionem Spiritus Sancti, et per adventum eiusdem Domini nostri aiudicium. Dicas mi nomen tuum.
Father Giuseppe. Father Giuseppe, what are they doing to you?
It's for my own good little brother, Father Raspberry.
must be driving out the devil.
The devil, you?
Oh, no. You're a saint. He's a saint.
Take this blasphemous fool out of here.
Oh, no. No, a moment. The Madonna. The Madonna. It's Father Giuseppe's.
Take him out.
Ecce crucem domine, fugite partes adverse.
Vigileo et primo iura radis David.
Domini exaudi orationem meam.
Clamor meam sacre veniat.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Oremus.
Adiuro te, serpens antique, per judicem divorum et mortuorum, per factorem tuum, per factorem mundi, per eum, qui avet potestatem mittere te in Gehenam. Ut ab hoc famulo Dei, impera tibi Deus. Impera tibi Maiestas Christi. Impera tibi Deus Pater. Impera tibi Deus Filius. Exi ergo transgressor. Exi seductor, plene omni dolo, et fallacia, virtutis inimice, innocentium persecutor, da locum dirissime, da locum impiissime, oremus.
Oramus te, Deus omnipotens. Ut spiritus iniquitatis amplius non aveat potestatem in hoc famulo tuo, Iosepho. Sed ut fugiat et non revertatur in unitate spiritus sancti Deus per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
As of this moment, you are free. You're no longer possessed by the devil. And now, let us leave Father Giuseppe alone with his penance. Will remain until morning.